Hi guys, this is Claudia from Yoga Fitness. Ready to start another practice of yoga with Claudia? Yeah? Let's do it. So bend your legs, yeah? Now, before you start to relax on the floor, yeah? Try to make a little adjustment with your hips and try to bring your hips like a tilting forward, so you will feel like you engage your lower belly, so you can feel more deeply your lower back, yeah? So bringing hips forward, belly a little bit, in a little bit, not tensing, yeah? And then press on your hips and your lower back and lengthen your spine a little bit further, bringing the chin toward the chest. And then spread your arms, yeah, nice and comfy. And just settle. Yeah? So allow your body to start to settle on the mat, on the floor. Even if you don't have time for a yoga class, even just this position, just lying down on the floor with your legs bended, will do a lot of benefit, will give you a lot of benefit for your back, yeah? Because you are allowing your back to spread and to stretch without doing any effort. And the gravity force is helping you to relax and to stretch the back, yeah? So start to focus on your breathing. And as you breathe out, allow your body to surrender more and more toward the floor. And as you fall, imagine that you are falling into the planet, but imagine the planet as a loving mother, yeah? Supporting you, minding you, giving you like a big hug as you fall, as you relax. And imagine expanding your roots really deep into the planet to create that sensation of being grounded, rooted, strong. Imagine those roots as always forming like a big net or web, really big, really chunky. And imagine the roots going deeply down to the very core of the planet, when we can start to absorb the energy of the planet. And we want to imagine that we get into that, the very center of the planet. So the energy that we receive is like a pure and untouched, yeah, of everything that is going on at the moment. So imagine receiving that energy into your roots when you breathe in. And when you breathe out, you feel, you keep feeling that you are falling. And in that falling also, you are starting to release all of the tension, the tightness, the stiffness, yeah, all that pain, all those aches. So imagine the roots are like channels or pipes on your back right now. Or you can imagine a huge pipe, yeah, whatever you prefer. And imagine that in that falling action, you are releasing the tension, releasing the pain. Yeah, immediately. And then in that space that is created, you are absorbing that new, fresh, pure energy of the planet. Yeah? And that energy will keep helping you to keep releasing, keep relaxing the tension. And you store as well that energy into yourself, into your body. And as always, we put in place that cocoon around us so we can save that extra energy for using later on, or to have it as a filter around us of protection, yeah? So with that in mind, yeah, doesn't matter if the visualization is great or not. Even if you can't visualize, the intention of putting this idea as we work will work, yeah? So keeping that sensation and that idea, we will start to open your arms back. Then moving a little bit your head side to side, yeah? Feeling the shoulder blades, yeah? Expanding. And then we will bring the arms up and we will bring one knee toward your belly. So when you catch the knee or your thigh, doesn't matter if you don't arrive to the knee, check that you are not tensing your upper arm. Yeah? Relax your elbows. Let the elbows fall heavy. And that action will bring the leg towards you. And you keep lengthening the back of the neck. So always you bring the chin toward the chest, okay, to lengthen the spine. Soften, relax. And then we open the knee to the side. Yeah, so one hand on the knee and one on the foot. Now, if this is not possible, you open your arms. Okay? Well done. And then we're lifting the leg up. Don't extend the knee completely, even if you can. Yeah? And we move the leg side to side. A little bit, doesn't need to be huge, just a little bit. We are using the weight of the leg to keep expanding the back. Yeah? Good. And then we do little circles. And then we bring that circle on your foot. Good. And flexing and stretching your foot and your toes. Well done. And then relax. We bring the other leg. Yeah, so when you catch the leg, again, recheck your chin. So bring the chin toward the chest, not lifting the head. The head is on the floor. It's just the direction of the chin toward your chest. That will lengthen your neck. And then check your shoulders and your elbows. You don't want add extra tension to your upper back. Yes, so elbows heavy, falling. And then stretch the leg up. Confío en the knee. Moving side to side. And little circles. And then moving your foot in circles. And flexing and stretching. Well done. We put that leg on the other leg, opening the knee. Open your back, yes. Yeah? So feel that you are nice and open on your back again. And then we bring the legs slowly up. Yeah. We can catch the leg or we can keep the arms open. Moving side to side, softly. Well done. And then rolling circles. Well done. And then we change, we put the other leg. And again, side to side. Very nice. And rolling circles. Well done. Now we will put the leg back to the floor. We will keep one leg. We will stretch that leg up again. We don't have to tense your knee. Yeah, the knee is soft. But flex your foot. So bring the toes like it toward your nose. Yeah, and we will do the exercise that we did last week. So again, bringing the chin toward the chest. Yeah, now you feel the lower back nice and connected. Okay, so with the heel, we will try to go all the way, far away to the floor. We don't have to arrive to the floor. You will decide with your back. So when you lower the leg, you press the lower back against the floor and you keep the belly a little bit in. When you feel that your lower back is about to arch, you relax the leg and you bring it back. You bring it back, yeah? So stretch, don't tense your knee. Heel, far away, far away, far away, far away, far away, far away, far away. Connecting lower back. When you are about to arch, release. And again, heel, far away, far away, far away, connecting lower back on the floor. Your lower back is glued to the floor, yeah? And one more time. Glute, glute, glute. Relax, well done. We put that leg on the floor. We change first leg to the belly. Stretch your leg up. Flex your foot with the heel far away, far away, far away, far away. Glute the lower back on the floor. And then relax. Yeah. So you keep the lower back on the floor. You don't want to arch in this position. So doesn't matter how low your leg. It's not about how low we go. It's about to keep the lower back. So the awareness is on your lower back. Yeah. This exercise is beautiful. It's create a beautiful stretch of the whole body and strengthen the back. Yeah. And the core. And having a strong muscles on the back and on the core is allowing the spine to be protected and supported all the time. Well done. Very nice. We bring both legs. Yeah. And we soften side to side. We need a little bit of both, the stretch and toning here to keep the spine in a good position. Good. And then the last one here, we will catch one knee. We will stretch the other leg. Now again, your belly, lower back is glued to the floor. So you stretch that leg, same idea. We don't have to go lower, 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 wherever you can, connecting the lower back on the floor. Yeah, elbows close. So you play with your foot there, wherever you can, without arching the lower back. Coming back, we catch the other leg. And again, grounding, 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 grounding. You go there. Very nice, relax, well done. And we roll toward one side. And we go to all fours. Good, so shoulders away. Remember, in these positions, always we move the shoulders away from your ears. Moving the hips in circles and connecting. So when you go forward, breathe in. When you go back, breathe out. Open your fingers, yeah, to use the weight of your body to stretch the joints of your fingers that we are a lot in claw position these days. Yeah, we go to the other side. Soften and relax. Well done. And then on the center, shoulders again away. We will look up and the bum is out. Let your belly now fall. Now we are not forcing the arch, it's just falling. And then press and round. Breathing open. Breathe out rounding. Breathing open. Breathe out rounding. One more time. Oh, well done. We curl the toes. We put the back of the toes on the floor. Spread your toes there. Expanding again, arching. And then when you round, we will squeeze the toes. Expand there. Breathe in, curl the toes, arching. Breathe out, rounding. Well done. We will open the knees and we go to child pose. So we lead with the hips far away back, wherever you can. Once you arrive with the hips, start slowly releasing first the belly between the legs, then your solar plexus, then your chest, and then your head. Don't rush going down because if not, we don't use fully the pose. Yeah? Shoulders away and surrender. With the breath out here, recover the image of the roots, the pipe. So in this position, you are able to release the tension that we carry on the back, on your lower back, on your hips. Yeah? So imagine releasing that pain. And we feel that space even more comfortable, more beautiful energy, soothing energy, healing energy. And we open the hands to one side. Yeah, we move the hands to one side. We relax, soften, surrender. And we go to the other side. Now we will come back to the center and we will put the arms, one stays on the front, the other, we are still in child pose, the other one is like a in cross. Now we are not forcing it, we try to soften in that position. Now the arm that is in cross is not pleasant, the sensation, we are trying to create a stretch on the arm, not forcing, you just relax. But you can feel like electricity feeling on that arm. Yeah, we are trying to create an space on the wrist and the fingers, a connection. We are working as a nervous system release there, okay? Then move that arm to the center and we go to the other arm, also in cross. And soften. And coming back, we go to all fours and we will stretch on the opposite way. Yes, so we bring the arm beneath, we put the shoulder on the floor. Then we put the head. When you put the head, don't put it too close to the shoulder. Put it like a more far away forward. So we create a nice space for the neck. And then the other arm to the front, comfy. And we soften like a child pose. Yeah? So the chest is toward the floor, toward the arm that is beneath you. Softening down, not forcing, softening. When we work in a stretch, remember that we want to soften on the breath out. That's the moment where the body relaxes and when the muscles open. Yeah? So that's the moment that you follow that sensation of the body to release and to relax. Good. And then we change, we go to the other side. Again, shoulder, then you put your head, and then your arm. And then coming back, we go to the front, shoulders away, and we will work with one leg. Yes, yeah? So again, shoulders away. We will move forward and back, rounding and arching your back in a soft way, a soft rhythm, following your breath. Breathing when you open back, breathe out when you round. And again, breathing in, expanding. Breathe around one more time. Both. In the next time when you are back, yeah, we will bend the leg. We will cross over the other leg. We stretch back and then we round forward. Yeah. So breathing back, cross, expand back, forward. One more time. Breathing up, cross, back, forward, one more time. Expand, back, expand, forward. We change, we go with the other leg. So we expand back, first back and forward. So rounding and expand, rounding and expand, rounding. And then we will cross over the other leg. That stretch the side of the leg and the hip. Yeah? And forward. One more time. Expand. Very nice. One more time. Good. Well done. Now we will stretch the leg back. Same idea with the heel pointing down now. We will work the shoulders, really important, at a way. Yeah? We are not tensing the upper arm. We will work with the lower back. Yes, yeah, so not with the belly. The lower back will go up. Yeah, imagine that you have a string and it's lifting the lower back up. That will engage the belly, but you start with the lower back. So lifting lower back, relax. Lifting lower back, relax. One more time. Lifting lower back. Every time that you go up, you engage a little bit your belly, but not that much that you hold your breath. Okay? And one more time. And then bending the leg. We go forward. We bring the knee like toward the head and round your back and keep the position. And relax. We do it with the other leg. Yes, so back. And again, through the lower back, lifting lower back, relax softly, lifting lower back, like when we do cat and dog, yeah? Lifting lower back, relax one more time, lifting lower back, bend the leg, we bring the knee forward, imagine that you want to touch with your knee your head, and relax, soften, well done. We will go to downward facing dog from here. So again, shoulders away, curl the toes, start like a child pose, yes? So we go with the hips first, and then you go with the hip far away back. The legs are bending. When you feel that you are really far away, you start to bring the belly and the chest toward your thighs, toward your knees, yeah? Toward the wall that you have behind you. Good. And then we start to work on the legs, like you're walking on the spot, yeah? Now, remember, if it's a long time that we don't do downward facing dogs or all fours, it's natural that you have a little bit of pain on the wrist, yeah? That will go away, like everything when we practice, yeah? So go back with your hips. Very nice. We will put the knees on the floor. Yeah, and we will go with one leg forward, the other leg forward. Yeah, and we will go up. Very nice. Cool. So feet comfortable there, shoulders away. Roll the shoulders a little bit. Now check that your knees are not tensing back, soft. Yeah? Not bending like a squat, but not tensing, yeah. Roll the shoulders, and we will take a nice deep breath, expand. And we start to stretch up. Now again, don't tense your legs here. This is really important if you are normally have pain on the back. Most of the back pain is related with your grounding, with the position of your legs and your feet, legs, feet, knees, and hips, yeah? So always remember that trick. Bring the knees soft. Whatever you are doing, wherever you are standing, check your knees, yeah? Now we will go here to the side. So again, here, normally we tend to do this tensing. Soften knees, soften shoulders, and expand far away. So you want the emphasis, the grounding of your feet will be the strong part. You feel the sole of your feet nice and grounding. That's your connection. You don't feel tension on here or on the shoulders, yeah? And then release, yeah? You are okay, Ursula? Yeah? I'm watching. Good, expand and release. Soften, relax. Well done. Good. So we'll start with a couple of some salutations. Yeah? So we will go to the top of the mat. Yeah, again, comfy on the knees. Yeah, yes. So check maybe the tablet, yeah, for your best position. Breathe in, open, expand. Imagine that you are absorbing that energy, remember your knees. Then when we go down, we soften knees, we go with the bum out, and we go like a child pose. So belly, solar plexus, chest and head, and we hang there. Relax the head, relax your abs, relax, 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 relax. Let go. Now we put the hands on the floor or on the sheets. Look up with your head. So table pose position on your back. Your bum is out, your head is up. In that position, we will go to plank. Yeah? So you put the hands on the floor, move your feet back. Shoulders again, away from your ears. Engage belly, engage your hips. The hips are tilting forward. Yeah? So it's not downward facing dog. Bring the hips in, belly in. We lengthen from the crown of the head to the heels. Yeah? Knees on the floor. Good. We will try one more time. Okay? So shoulders away, heels. Check your hips. Yes? Yeah? So in and lower. Straight from the head to the heels. Well done. Knees on the floor. And we will go. We can do or all fours and arching, or we can try to lower the chest toward the between the hands with your elbows closer to each other. So when you go down, don't go with your elbows open, close it. Yeah. So we go chest and chin, and then we pull a little bit forward to put the belly on the floor. We will start slowly. So hips are in, belly is in, elbows are close to your body, your chest is tiny lifted, the head is a little bit up, but not forcing your neck back, yeah? You feel your pubic bone, you feel your belly, you feel even your solar plexus on the floor, elbows are closer, your shoulders are rolled back, yeah? Keep the position for a little bit, yeah? Don't rush it, squeeze. Elbows toward the back. We are strengthening the back also to have less pain. Now we push, we go up to all fours, and we will go to downward facing dog, hips back. Keep the knees bent, open your chest, and then relax your heels. Open. Now we will bring the right leg forward toward the hands. We can go directly. If you stay halfway, yeah, you can help with the hand, bringing the foot more forward. So when you go up, you are already in the position. Yeah? Or we can put the knees on the floor and then your foot. We will go directly to warrior one. Yeah? So we will face the front. Hips forward, the foot comfortable. Yeah, you don't want to have the ankle all painful there, comfy. Hips leading forward, squaring forward. Doesn't need to be perfect. Knee. So you don't fall into the arch of your foot. Keep the arch open, active. Keep the knee. So you are on the ball of your foot and your heel. Don't let the arch fall. This is really important, and that will give you stability for your normal movements in your life. Belly in, shoulders away, we're lifting the arms. Not tensing, relaxing. Yeah? Relax. Relax the hips. Yeah? Don't force the back foot, comfy. Don't tense your knee, soft. Yeah? We will put the hands in prayer position, shoulders away. Yeah? And we will open one more time, chest open, shoulders away. Lifting, catch the hands, open, shoulders away. One more time, breathe in, expand, shoulders away, softly up. Don't tense your shoulders. And then you put the hands toward the heart, elbows. One more time. Breathe in. Expand. Hands in prayer position. Very nice. Now from there, we will go forward toward the floor, back to plank, lengthen, take your time, shoulders away. So remember, hips tilting forward, belly in, head forward, knees on the floor, chest and chin toward the hands to that lower cobra, belly in, elbows closer to your body, lengthen. Now feel the top of your toes toward the crown of your head like a lengthening. You are engaging your shoulder blades. Don't lift the head, yeah? Feel the belly engage, connected with the floor. Then curl the toes, you push hips up, back to downward facing dog, expand, open, spread back. Good, we bring the left leg forward. Warrior one. So again, you can catch the leg and push it forward before you go up. Yeah? The intention is that you don't go up with your knee in this position. That is really bad for your knee. So if you are there, yeah, before you go up, you move and then you go. Yeah. Cool. So hips forward, shoulders, expand. Comfy, you are grounded, strong. Yeah, shoulders away. Relax your hips. When you relax, check that you don't do this. Open. We are working in hips as well. Strengthen legs, strengthen hips, strong here. Yeah. Remember, don't fall with the arch. Ball of your foot, toes and heels. Bring the hands, great position. Open, we are not touching back, restrain. Breathe in, open, open. Solar plexus, chest big to receive all that energy that is available. And then bring it to your heart, yeah? Breathe in, lifting energy, receiving. Belly's in at all time to your heart. One more time, expand. Well done. Open, we go back to the floor to plank. Lengthen, lengthen, shoulders away. Check your hips, tilting the hips forward, belly in, knees on the floor. Elbows are closer to your body, yeah? We go down, pulling a little bit. Yeah, elbows are closer to your body. Very nice, very nice. Shoulders away. Good. Then you push and then up. Well done. Downward facing dog. Expand, open, 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 open. And then we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And then slowly up. Well done. Good. We will put the hands here, like in the cobra position. Yeah. Now the bum is out. Now the opposite. Bum is out. Yeah. So check the difference between this, that you feel the stretch here, and this. Yeah. Hands. Elbows, shoulders not here, here. Well done, expand, open, very nice. Now from here, we will put again the hands in prayer position, yeah? And softly, we don't move here, we rotate a little bit to the side. Your knees are forward, we are not. A little bit, shoulders away. Lengthen the spine, yeah? Your spine is long. We are strengthening and stretching at the same time. Twists are good to release the pain. So I stay there. You don't have to go low, low, here. Coming back. Bum is out. We go to the other side. So you keep your center. Check that you are not, it's not a ski. Centering. Yeah, Jack. Well done. Coming back. Very nice. From there, relax. Soften. Breathing open. We go back. Shoulders away. Knees on the floor. Chest and chin. Again, elbows closer like we just did. Yeah? We go forward. And now hips are tilting forward again. You push with your pubic bone, your thighs into the floor, lifting chest a tiny bit, head up, but not forcing. Good. We go back, curl the toes. Expand, open. Breathe deeply. We bring the right leg forward again to warrior one. Yeah? Hips. Shoulders. Expand. Go. Not tensing. Again, hands, preposition. We do exactly the same. We are not going low. Lifting. We rotate toward your thigh. Yeah? Not this way. To the thigh. Rotate. Wherever is comfortable. It doesn't have to be huge. A little bit. And concentrating, lengthening. Lengthening here. We are not forcing it. Eh? It's wherever you can. Shoulders away. Your chest is open. Yeah. So when you rotate, you are not rounding. Open. Connecting. We are not forcing the knee either. The knee soft. Just that. Don't go low. Just here. We want to stretch. Yeah. Good. Well done. Coming back. We spread one more time. We go down. Back to plank. Last one. Yeah, shoulder. No, one more. One more. We go chest and chin. Elbows closer to your body. Pull forward to connect belly, pubic bone, elbows closed. We go back. Hips. Expand back. Well done. And we bring the left leg forward. Again, ground it. Yeah. And expand. Yeah. Again, arch of your foot active. Knee open. Yeah. You don't want to see your knee in the center. The knee is pointing toward the toes. Belly strong. Open. Check the shoulders. Yes. Hands. Check, check, check. Yeah, comfy. And again, this is lifting. Imagine that we are doing a twist sitting. We rotate slowly. Here, you don't have to feel pain on the foot, on the knee. It's just a simple rotation wherever is comfortable. Shoulders away. Yeah. Check that you are not tensing or rounding. Open. Yeah. The knee, important, don't tense it. Soft. You are yielding, so you can receive. Yeah. Open. Very nice. Expansion. Yes. Open, receive. Yeah. Good. Coming back. Well done. Coming, coming, coming. Shoulders away. Back to plank. Well done, ladies. Open chest, shoulders away, hips tilting forward. Yeah, knees on the floor. Last one. Chest and chin, and we pull forward. Elbows closer to your body. Touch pubic bone, groins, shoulders away. Lengthen the spine. And then back. Last one. Expand, open. Far away, open your chest. Not forcing, it's just you want to spread, to let go. It's the difference of the quality of the stretch. Open to release, to receive. Not open because I have to, yeah? Because you want to spread. And then we open the knees, we go to child pose. This time we will put the hands beneath your forehead and spread your elbows. Yeah. So Check that your elbows are going toward the sides. Yeah, like an opening.
Soften. Release. Let go there. Very nice.
Now, without changing, just we only will change the hands. So you put the other hand now on the top and you let it spread there. I know it feels super weird, really uncomfortable. Not myself at all. That's normal. Just stay there. We are bringing balance to the shoulder blades, to the neck. Surrender. Well done. Coming back slowly. Very nice. Well done, ladies. Now, if you like to stay in hero pose, yeah, you can check. Maybe you want to put a pillow beneath your feet. Now, if this is not comfortable, you sit. Normal sitting. Even legs open. Or on a chair, doesn't matter because we're working the upper body. As always, when we do hero pose, it's only to add a little bit of work on the legs. That's all, yeah? Hero pose is to work in this area. So it doesn't matter if you can't, yeah? Or if you want to try, you do a little bit and then you go up. Yeah, okay, good. So comfy there, shoulders away. Now, imagine that you ground your hips into your feet or into your cushion, or if you are sitting into the floor, yeah, really pushing down and feel that lifting on the spine here, shoulders away, open your arms, yeah? Check your arms, yeah? Not this, soften, like a butterfly. Good. That's the sensation that we want, yeah? And then you push into the hips again, lifting more your chest, yeah? So we want to create a nice open on the chest, not bringing the arms behind, because that position is look like we are working more, but actually the shoulder is going up, so that tends the neck. So we create worse sensation than the ones we want to release, yeah? So open chest. And then we will round. Imagine that you give a big hug, yeah, to everyone that you want to hug there. Chuk, chuk, chuk. We will cross. We will bring it to your heart, yeah. Elbows, yeah. Lock in there. And then we lift in the hands, yeah. Shoulders away, chest open, yeah. And we will do little circles with your arms, yeah? The shoulders are trying to go down. It's not a comfortable position, eh? They're working on, open and release the tension. Same position, don't change, just change the direction on the circle. Well done. Now, the arm that is up, yeah? The arm that is up, goes up, yeah? The arm, doesn't matter if it's different arm of me, yeah? Up, the other one goes down. Again, shoulders away, yeah? Doesn't matter if we are in different position. You follow the arm that was up, is up. Yeah, so we don't mess too much. We put the hand behind, wherever you can. The other hand behind, wherever you can. When you put it, remember to roll again the shoulder. Yeah, don't keep it here. Back, back, back. So we release these muscles here. Spread. Open. Very nice. Well done. Now, we will change the same position. Eh? So we will spread arms. Doesn't matter if you are with the other arm. Eh? We change. We put the other arm on the top. We put the hand back. We put the other hand back. Roll the shoulder away, spread. Well done. We open up again. Now this arm that is on the top, we will go on the top when we cross. Yeah. So we open again. Imagine leading to a big hug. This arm that was up will go up again. Yeah. So we will cross over the other one. You lock, like you include that hook here. You have everything, everyone here, and you lock it. And then check. Shoulders away, chest open, roll, circles. Well done, the opposite direction. Well done, relax. You put the arms on your legs or on the floor, wherever you feel more comfortable. Roll the shoulders, relax your elbows. Just stay with your chest, your solar plexus nice and open. And imagine sending all that tension that you discover as you move, boom, to the floor. And you are receiving a more soft, a more supple energy into your upper back there, to your neck, into your shoulders. Beautiful. Well done. Now we will lie down on the back again, knees bending. Good. So, belly in. So again, rolling the hips forward, belly a little bit in. Bring the chin a little bit forward toward the chest and lengthen the spine, shoulders away and spread here. So take your time here to feel. So first try to connect your hips and your shoulder blades. Yeah? So imagine that rectangle where the legs are like a table. The legs are your hips and your shoulder blades, the four legs of that table. Now check for a moment, because normally we tend to be more on one side. We have always one hip that is more on the floor usually, and the shoulders the same. That's the imbalance that we carry, and that's normal. We all have it. Now do a little effort of bringing awareness there and move to check if you can feel equally balanced in both sides or the four legs. So hips and shoulder blades. Yeah? Imagine that you want to have a nice table balance, equal, so the things doesn't fall from the table. Yeah. Good. And press. Imagine that you're pressing with hips and shoulders to the floor to increase that sensation, that awareness. Well done, and relax. Now from there, we will bring the hips tilting forward again, the belly in, and we will go in this position to bridge it. So we'll push into the feet, lifting the hips here. Yeah? So the hips are tilting forward, bring the chin toward the chest, grounding those, the top of your shoulders there and the back of the head. We want to lengthen the neck there. Arms are comfy, belly is in. And you press with your feet to lift in your thighs and your groins. It's not tensing that you can breathe. It's a nice grounding, a strong pushing with your feet, like you commanding the roots, yeah, to go up. So you are being held and helped by the roots, by the planet. And in that pushing, you are receiving. You remember the pipe image, you're receiving. From the feet, all up to your body. The body is overflowing and you are feeling that cocoon around you. And then relax, release. And we bring the knees to your belly. Well done, beautiful. We did a lot of back, so we don't need too many bridge today. Yeah. So from here, really slowly, even we will go to spinal twist. So even the best way is you put the feet one on the floor or both, and then you rotate safely to the side. Open your arms. And then spread. Yes, you spread your arms And soften. Again, the sensation of falling into the arms of the planet. So now is the planet who is hugging you. And you are aware of that cocoon around you. Yeah, so you are receiving energy now. Imagine a beautiful, loving, caring, protective, healing, cleansing energy that is you receive it from the planet, if you prefer from the from above, from the sun, or for both. Yeah, I tend to work this the last few months more with the planet because for the grounding sensation, eh? To keep rooted and strong. But we can work with both, yeah? And then you put again with the top of your toes, yeah? You walk a little bit and you move a little bit the hip to the other side to go to the other side, yeah? Shoulders again away. Soften your ground, surrender. Imagine that huge pipe or the roots receiving the remaining tension and sending you instead loving energy, unconditional loving energy, pink light. You can use the green for healing. You can use red if you need the sensation of being more strong. Orange light if you need to work more on the emotional aspect of yourself. Yellow if you need joy and energy, yeah, pure energy. Pink and green for the heart, turquoise for your communication, for your neck, also for the neck pain. Indigo and violet for your connection with your higher self. And then back into the center and we go to Shavasana. Yeah, so you can use all those colors around you, or choose the color that is coming more to you in this moment. Nice and comfy. You can put your blankets if you need. So picture yourself again with that huge pipe beneath you. You are absorbing all the energy that you need with the kind of quality that you need, those lights. Imagine the cocoon around you, yeah? And imagine receiving all that into your body, to yourself. And at the same time, you will receive another extra energy. Imagine this energy is coming from my side, yeah? Like an extra loving touch or energy. And imagine this energy will give you more relaxation, more comfort, more peace. So imagine that energy there, arriving now into your feet, into your heels, moving up through the sole of your feet, your toes, moving through the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs, your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving through your shoulders, into your arms, your hands, your fingers, into your wrists, elbows, shoulders, into the back of your neck, your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax.
And now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. From there we fall to one side, bending your knees, and we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs and breathing deeply. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class this morning, and I thank you for sharing your time and your practice.
Hi guys, I hope you enjoy the class. Now don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss my other videos and classes. See you next time. Bye.